should say this.
I think it's an important
point. I think the president is a coward when it comes to helping our kids who are afraid of gun violence. I think he is cruel when he doesn't deal with helping our dreamers, of which we're very proud. I think he's in denial about the climate crisis. However, that's about the election. This is about the elect. Take it up in the elect. This is about the Constitution of the United States and the facts that lead to the president's violation of his oath of office. And as a Catholic, I resent your using the word hate in a sentence that addresses me. I don't hate anyone. I was raised in a way that is full, a heart full of love, and always prayed for the president. And I still pray for the president. I pray for the president all the time. So don't mess with me when it comes to words like that.
Welcome.
I think the president is a coward when it comes to helping our kids who are afraid
of
gun violence. I think he is cruel when he doesn't deal with helping our dreamers, of which we're very proud. I think he's in denial about the Constitution, about the climate crisis. However, that's about the election.
Have you ever wondered where we will find the food,
this is about the Constitution of the United States
we will need
and the facts
to sustain the world's exploding population in the years ahead?
And as a Catholic,
in the timeless distances of outer space,
in a sentence that addresses me, I don't.
The technology of today is already helping us penetrate the silent darkness of space. Man himself has taken the first tiny step into this vast unknown. And we can only imagine what resources will soon be brought back to Earth by these early pioneers. But what about our own Earth? Are there not still resources here to meet the needs of the world tomorrow? What about that great unexplored continent at the bottom of our Earth, larger than the United States and Europe combined? Already, Antarctica has become a great scientific laboratory for men of all nations to discover great new land areas rich with natural resources. Antarctica is but one area of great promise for the future. What about the others? What about the sea? We have long sailed its surface and fished its depths. But at the very bottom is a land of undreamed of abundance, with enough food to feed the Earth's population seven times over. There are rich ores and minerals carried by submarine trains to process stations on the coast. There is the water itself, to be drained from the sea and made precious rain,
helping our dreamers,
to turn desert lands into fertile lands. There will even be new areas for living and working.
That's about the election.
A whole new dimension of life for people of the future.
This is about the Constitution.
Now, consider the thick, lush lands of the equator. Here, nature flourishes in its greatest abundance. Technology has finally led the way into the wild profusion of the jungle world. One day, this land will be transformed into land for farms and pastures for cattle. From the abundance of equatorial jungles, the barrenness of great mountain ranges, the future offers great promise. Once barriers to man's progress, the mountains will soon be traversed by multiple highways that will soar over canyons and cut through towering walls and cracks. It will carry a life stream of minerals and other natural resources to the thriving industries tomorrow. Highways, too, will open up the great expanses of desert land, one day to be made fertile again by waters pumped from sea and river, from dams and mountain streams. The highways from great new centers of agriculture and industry will lead inevitably to the metropolis of tomorrow. Access will be easy to the heart of the city, the core. In and around great cities like this will live many of the people of the future.
The president is a coward
of limitless hope and promise.
To helping,
and nowhere will this be more evident
kids
to the homemaker than in the kitchen of the future.
Of gun violence. I think he is cruel when he doesn't deal with.
Remember the ultra-modern home exhibit we visited earlier today?
Of which we're very
the wonderful new concepts you saw in the kitchen?
I couldn't believe it.
However,
that's certainly understandable.
That's
it's hard to believe there actually is an oven that can cook a roast in minutes. By
this
electronics,
about the
then bake you potatoes in less
States
time than it takes to carve the roast.
That leads to the president's violation of his oath of office. And as a Catholic,
and remember that new idea for the family that enjoys casual living, a refrigerated cart, ready for wheeling into a game room or out onto the patio, perfect for keeping foods and drinks cool for informal entertaining.
Yes, that's a wonderful idea.
Now let's continue our journey into imaginative design and new concepts from the far corners of the world.
Why, it's just like being on the Mediterranean. Good heavens, I really am. How wonderful. Yummy. Beautiful.
Is a coward
and all that room for fresh food, too.
Kids who are afraid. I think he is cool when he doesn't deal with helping our dreamers, of which we're very proud. I think he's in denial about the constitution, about the climate crisis. However,
my goodness,
that's about the election.
How can so much
this
frozen food fit
into
such a small space?
This is about the Constitution of
and
the
no
United
frost,
States
either.
And the facts that lead to the president's violation of the oath of office. And as a Catholic, I resent using the word hate in a sentence that addresses me. I don't hate anyone. I was raised in a way that is full, a heart full of love. Pray for the president, and I still pray for the president. I pray for the president all the time.
Just look
so
at how much
don't mess
this
with me when
holds.
It comes to words like that.
Well, I must say, I certainly am getting around. Now I seem to be in the exotic East. I can sure use a good cup of tea about now. My, what a beautiful kitchen. Look what's over here, a laundry center. How convenient. And I'll bet this washer will get anything clean, even my most delicate things. Simple these controls are.
Voice and code 1B, 2B, 3. Verified and correct. Destruct sequence completed and engaged. Awaiting final code for 30-second countdown.
It happened again. Now I'm in the
there's something I like. Lots of refrigerator space and frost proof, too. Smells good over here. Ah, I'll have to sample that. Ooh, that's hot.
My family will never believe me.
Hey, Mom, is dinner ready?
Coming right up. How does it look?
Delicious. Hi, Dad.
Hi. Looks good. Well, I'll start the car, and you can tell us about going back to the World's Fair today.
Did you have fun?
I sure did. Everything I saw was out of this world.